So first thing I thought was, it's not Silent Night. I always thought, Silent Night. But actually this is Still the Night. Holy the Night.
Right.
Which, because everybody goes Silent Night, as in shh, no noise. But that made me think, okay, what's the difference between stillness and silence, as in absence of noise? So I started from there, and then I looked at the three verses, and I thought, you know, in films, when they frame things, so you have shots of different things, and the first one, it's almost as though we're zooming in to the nativity scene, and it's almost like you have the picture, the tableau of the nativity, mm-hmm. and it's all beautiful in it. And then you move from there to the shepherds, so a different placement, somewhere different from this nativity scene. But then you've got the angels, and it becomes grander. You know, this isn't just a baby. This is, wow, Christ the Redeemer is here. And then the last verse, Son of God, oh how bright, love is smiling from thy face. Is this the baby in the nativity, or are we imprinted now onto the risen, ascended Lord?
Carry on.
That's my theological question. So it strikes us now, the hour of grace, Saviour since thou art born. You've almost got those imprints of, you've got the nativity and you've got the resurrected Christ in the same moment. And of course then you've got that feeling of, this is a pivotal moment. This is time when history changed. You know, when the human race, something happened for them. So that idea of stillness isn't about no noise, it's about expectancy. You know, so at the start it says, you know, everyone's sleeping, and then hidden away mm-hmm. is this little tableau. But then right at the end, we are woken up, and yes, Saviour. So you get that movement through the carol. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. It's good. A lot of thinking there.
So I was thinking, so Still the Night, it's not really like silent, it's creating that framing, that like an opening scene in a film, where you get the panning shot to establish where we are, and then it focuses in on the action. So I was thinking something like, it's like night, but there's a kind of, you know, there's a wonderment about it. It's a special night. It's not just night as in not day, it's kind of like night. And then holy the night, holy. Because of course you can have lots of different signs for holy, but this is kind of just establishing, maybe special, that this is something special. Sleeps the world, semicolon, hid from the sight. I always, because you sing it as one line, but actually the punctuation is, you know, everybody's asleep. And then this is happening at the same time as these people are asleep. Mary and Joseph in stable bare. So it's that whole thing about, which that doesn't do. Stable bare doesn't really have that kind of griminess or messiness or animal stuff about it. So you have Mary and Joseph, unless maybe you're West Coast Joseph. animal shelter there. Watch over child, beloved and friend. Child's got a capital C. The child, that one. Not any baby, that one. So hang on. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So, and then there they are, watching over a child, beloved and fair, sleeping in heavenly rest, refers back to Jesus. So, yeah, not just, yeah, sleeping, but there's something about this heavenly rest, this kind of sense of peace, as in shalom, as in wholeness, as in, do you know what I mean? Not just resting, but sleeping. That kind of, everything's as it should be. It's good. This is, you know. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
So sleeping in heavenly peace or something, because it's something about heaven looking down on this child and it all being okay, you know. Sleep. Heavenly peace. Shall we go through that again?
Yes. No, could you remind me what Joseph is? Very slowly, Joseph is.
J-H.
Oh, right.
Joseph.
Joseph. Yeah, right, got you.
There's a Joseph as well. See, I'm not sure if it's a Joseph or Joseph or Joseph. You would have to ask somebody from the West Coast. Mm-hmm. So, and as I don't have a Glaswegian accent, we're going for Joseph.
To do that.
But then Mary is a virgin, so V for virgin, Mary, because of her. So that's the easy one. Okay. So what did I do? Goes a bit high for me to sing. Okay. So I don't know whether we want to do the same. Yeah, maybe just repeat the first line. Mm-hmm. So. And then we've got the shepherds. So I'm going to put the shepherds separate from where the people are sleeping and where Mary and Joseph are. They're going to be out here. So you can have shepherds or shepherds or shepherds, people, sheep looking after. Yes, or because you don't have to do light at all. No, I heard we sounding like clear and loud, far and near the angel song. So, da, 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 because that's their reaction.
Yeah.
And that gives that sense of holiness as well, because it's another site for holy. So you've got this whole sentence and a bit that then describes the angel's song. So in sign language, we need to put who's doing it first. So the angels singing to them, so singing downwards. And then we keep da, 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 da. And then we become the angels, role shift, because they're the ones that are singing Christ's Redeeming is here, not shepherds. Mm-hmm. So we've been the shepherds and their reaction, and then we turn to Christ. I don't like that Christ, it's a bit. Christ, the Redeemer, is here, and then we can put him down into where the baby is.
Great.
Christ, the Redeemer, is here.
So do that again.
Or is here. The Redeemer is here. Because the third one says Son of God, which is up here, down. So the first verse is about the humanness of Jesus the baby, and then the angels are saying there's something special about this baby, and then the last verse is saying this is the Son of God. Okay. So it's divine, so you go from the human to the divine, and this is the in-between bit. So Christ the Redeemer is here. Christ the Redeemer is here. Okay. Because then you've got that in-between bit of he's a man but actually, well, he's a baby but something special about them. Yeah. So, okay, shall we go to that? Make sense?
Yes.
So that angel song, and then you turn and you become the angels in a very angelic way. I always think of angels as being quite strong, aren't they? Mm-hmm. People are never like, oh, it's an angel. They're like, oh, it's an angel.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, Christ the Redeemer. Okay. Third verse.
I'm just watching you all the time.
Well, you can correct me on my theology.
No, not at all. Well, there's a lot of thinking going into it.
So, still the night. Holy the night. Right, Son of God, oh how bright. There's a whole Son of Man, Son of God thing that, wow. But this is the bit that goes, he's not just a baby, there is this link between heaven and earth. I probably go Son of God, bright, because then you've got God come down. Face, love for us. And it's almost like realization of wow, you know, this is for us. You know, at the start we were sleeping and unaware and it was all hidden, but now it's revealed. Strikes us now the hour of grace. So now, you know, and the grace is coming from God to us. So what did I do? Now, grace for us. And then there's that realization at the end, Saviour, as in like, you're my Saviour.
Mm-hmm.
You know, not just, so there's a Saviour of the world, but also my, this is
mm-hmm.
me. And the fact that Saviour, born, it's like Saviour since you were born. So that whole thing about you were right from your birth, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Saviour. Oh, something is about your baby, but your Saviour.
Mm-hmm.
That kind of in your head, comprehending that this baby becomes this Christ on the cross, which becomes this Christ ascended, and they're all, wow.
All for us.
Yes. I said, it's kind of like not so much the what signs you use, it's the what expression is on your face, and you're telling a story, you know, and you're saying to people, do you get it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That's the, do you get it, you know? Baby Saviour, maybe. Yeah. Baby Saviour. And that kind of leads us into worship as well. Saviour. And then, whatever. Well, for me anyway, it's kind of like at the end you go, ah, wow. Not kind of, oh, baby, sweet. It's kind of like
amazing, ooh, awesome.
Yes, and also there's that tinge of, oh, this baby and is going to go through all this stuff as well. And
all for us.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what did I do? So he's got that special night here, holy the night. What did I say? Son of God.
Son of God.
So we become then onlooker, that we see Jesus. So it's like, it's almost like we've pushed aside Mary and Joseph,
mm-hmm.
and we've come to look over at this baby, you know, and just that kind of, so from your face, love is given out. God's grace for us. Well, no, should we go through all of it?
Yes.
I'm not saying this is the definitive translation, but it at least has why. Okay. Yeah. Sorry, because sometimes I kind of change it as I go.
No, it's fine, fine. Yeah, no, no, it's fine. Honestly.
And then at the end I was like, so what's your response to this is a set way you would worship? And
mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yeah.